Have you ever paused and asked yourself this question? कि यार आई विश आई कुड हैव अ लिटिल मोर मीनिंग एंड पर्पज टू लाइफ. मेरे साथ ये बहुत होता है. आई एम एट अ फेज वेयर आई एम कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्राइंग टू फिगर थिंग्स आउट फॉर माई सेल्फ. बट आई थिंक ओवर द ईयर्स आई हैव गैदर्ड सम पर्सपेक्टिव ऑब्वियसली विद माई कॉन्वर्जेशन विद फेलो ट्रैवलर्स एंड द बुक्स दैट आईव रेड. एंड आई डिसाइडेड टू मेक अ वीडियो एंड कंपाइल एवरीथिंग दैट आईव लर्न एंड माई जर्नी सो फार. Having said that, in no way do I claim to be expert here. I'm just another 29-year-old who's sitting here trying to figure things out for himself. Agar kuch nahi to, I hope at least you get to learn something new from this video. Let's do it. So I met this really interesting guy in Kerala who actually gave me a lot of perspective. He's just 24 years old. So this boy was trying to detach himself from his family and the world. He hasn't used his cell phone for the past 3 years. He was a minimalist in a true sense, who was living out of a backpack. He's an artist who was trying to barter his skills at these hostels for food and stay. He told me, if you truly want to find yourself and your purpose in life, there are two things that are really important. One, never set a goal for yourself very early on in this journey. Go out there, try different things, meet a lot of people and gather as much perspective as possible. That's exactly when you'll be able to find your true calling or causes that you really believe in. Well, this is a spiritual journey. If you set a goal for yourself very early on in this journey, more often than not, you'll realize that it was just a phase in life and not your true calling. He told me most people in life won't do it because we as humans want the details and we are scared to set into the unknown. We often get carried away with me and my life and don't realize that our journey in life is bigger than our own personal story. अच्छा तो मजेदार बात यह है कि I've been a part of a lot of these conversations about life which just goes on for hours, but at the end we unanimously decide that happiness is a choice and we leave the discussion right there. I find it really funny to meet somebody who really had fresh perspective around this topic, and more importantly he was living his life a certain way because he believes in his ideas and concepts. It was very refreshing. Having said that, मेरे को लगता है सबकी commitment and situations बहुत अलग होती है. For somebody like me, I feel like I've made peace with the fact that I might never be able to find my true calling or meaning in life, which is completely okay with me. So it depends how you really want to take it. And there are a few other perspectives that I've gained over the years. That is by reading a few books that has really had an impact on me. I would like to share that as well in case it helps. Back in Okinawa, Japan, there is a concept of ikigai, which literally means your reason for being. It is believed that we all have a special reason for existence. Let's try to understand this with a diagram. To find your ikigai, you need to put in the work to understand what do you love doing. What are you good at? What can you get paid for? And what the world needs. Now the first intersection is your passion, because that's what you love doing. The second intersection is your profession, because you can get paid for it. The third intersection would be your vocation, your calling or your niche. And eventually your fourth intersection is going to be your mission in life. Now, iske jo beech ka intersection hai, that is your reason for being or your ikigai. And quite frankly, there's no rocket science here. You need to believe your gut or your intuition. You need to go try new things. Probably you'll fail at a few things, but eventually you'll find something that you're really passionate about. And hopefully you can start working towards your ikigai. Now I understand this is a very complex topic to talk about, but then I was recently speaking to a surgeon friend of mine, and she had a different perspective around the whole topic. She outright said, meaning, purpose, fulfillment, whatever you call it, that can't be the ultimatum everybody's craving for. What she meant by that was, she's been in medicine for about 10 years now, and all she craves for is a week off at home without expecting any phone calls from wards and patients. One thing that she can never get used to is patients dying in front of her. But at the same time, she's very convinced that this is something that really gives her a lot of meaning and purpose. So my two cents on the topic is, yaar, sabki situation, life, circumstances are very different. You can just go ahead, read as many books as you would like. Meet people, gather as much perspective as you would like, but there is no guarantee that something that has worked for somebody else would work for you. So just go out there, do everything that you believe in, and hopefully you will find some purpose to your life as well.